Polymer swell is a common phenomena in polymer extrusion process. In extrusion, when polymer melt comes out from the die orifice, it expands, or in simple words, we can say that it swells. Due to swelling, the diameter of extruded fiber is larger than the diameter of the die. This behavior of polymer is called die swell. Die swell is also known as Barras effect. Polymers show die swell behavior due to their viscoelastic nature and entropy. As we know, in a polymer melt, chains are present in coiled form and entropy of the melt is very high. When a polymeric material goes inside the die, it undergoes high shearing. Due to applied shearing force, polymer chains starts to uncoil and straighten up. As a result, entropy goes down. As the material comes out from the die, the shearing force acting on polymer chains is removed, and chains starts to coil up again and try to regain their high entropy coiled structure. So, during die swell, polymeric material undergoes elastic deformation. When force is applied, polymer chains starts to deform. When force is removed, chains go back to initial shape. This behavior of polymer is called stress relaxation. So, due to viscoelasticity and entropy, polymers show die swell behavior. We can measure die swell ratio by dividing extruded fiber diameter by the diameter of the die, or we can calculate die swell in percentage also. So, if we know die swell percentage of a polymer, we can calculate diameter of the die to get the fiber of fixed diameter. Knowledge of die swell of a polymer is very important, particularly when we want to make fibers of fixed diameter or hollow pipes with fixed inner or outer diameter. If swelling is inadequate or more, can cause processing problems and defects in the finished product. Die swell can be minimized by increasing the melt temperature, increasing die length, reducing shear rate, and increasing extrusion speed. Other than these factors, die swell also depends on material type and diazimetry. So there are many factors that need to be taken care to minimize the die swell. A better understanding of die swell behavior of a polymer will lead to a better product quality and production cost.